of VMA 225 from 1963 through 1965, as recorded by Carol McGuire. As of July the 1st, 1991, VMA 225 has been reactivated in El Toro.
At the time, the A-4 was the workhorse of the close airs of the Marine Corps. The aircraft was built by Douglas, and VMA 225 had approximately 30 in their fleet. Each one was maintained by a crew chief, several mechanics specialists, an ordnance, avionics, power plant, and safety equipment, and many other support staff. It was necessarily a team effort. In preparation for the inevitable 13-month deployment to Japan, the squadron had short assignments to various locations. Rota, Spain, Yuma, Arizona, Roosevelt Roads, Puerto Rico, and the Enterprise, an atomic-powered naval carrier, thus earning the squadron the name of Vagabonds. Get to many of these destinations, it was necessary to refuel mid-air from the 130s, which was not always an easy task. 130s could reel into two buckets out for air, two of our aircraft to plug into and stay engaged for approximately 15 minutes in order to take on necessary fuel to extend the range of our mission. The purpose of being in Yuma was ordnance practice and designated ranges, which had the capability of pinpointing the exact location of impact. Les Townsend, then 20 years old, was recognized for his bullseye.
They'll make you welcome, they'll take your request. My kind of people, and my kind of crowd, they say play your guitar, boy, and turn it up loud. There's a place in Carolina, it's almost the same. Only the faces and the names have been changed.
Wandering through the aircraft fuel tanks are Tom Dohoney, Ralph Stewart, Tom King.
I need to go home, and it's my home away from home.
This Townsend flying with me across country was